How do you manage that in Japan? Because in the Netherlands it's kind of simple because we make very tight contracts. So we in the contract there's a very clear scope definition. So this is what we're going to charge you, and this is what is included, and this is what is not included. So basically, if there is any discussion later on, we just look at the contract and say, well, this is what we were going to do. It is not in the contract. You requested it. But basically, it's the task of the project manager to say, if you want this, it's out of scope.
Okay, if many managers working for there, thousand, 2,000 managers working there, some of those they do not know clear definition for the sub-client customer service. They decided to expand their scope unwillingly. This kind of should be happen. If so many people working there, some people are reluctant to negotiate the customer to stop wider scope, no?
But that's unacceptable. As a client, I would say, really, if I request this and this is out of scope and you do not notify me about this and send me a bill later, sorry, I will not pay. It's up to the supplier to make sure that you don't get out of scope, or if there is a scope creep or scope change in scope, you need to notify the steering committee and ask for approval before you proceed. Otherwise, basically, you can grow your own revenue by just following the customer wherever he wants to go.
Yeah, I think especially American overseas company, they are very strict management for scope.
Absolutely. So scope management is super important. If there's something I learned working as a project manager in IT, it's scope management.
So
That's how you make or lose
very
money.
rare exception, right? What you mean?
No, it's very common.
Very.
This is absolutely common in Europe and in America in terms of IT project, and I think any project. It has a benefits, but it also has big disadvantages, and I think that's why nowadays we don't see these waterfall projects anymore, because it has zero flexibility in terms of scope. And any project there will be questions, because when you design the project you're not fully exposed to the people who actually need to use the system. So once you start to actually roll out as planned, you will realize that, oh shit, this doesn't work, it doesn't meet their needs, and will be a big problem if we don't change it. Now, if you don't have a clear if you have a clear scope definition, then anytime something like that happens, you need to go to the steering committee, ask for approval for additional budget. Now, a lot of IT companies, including the one that I was working for, they knew that. So every time we would meet the client, a new client, we would ask them, how much budget do you have? And we would make a proposal that would fit their budget. It would always fit their budget. But what they wanted was much bigger than their budget. Now, of course, we know the software. We know exactly how much it would cost to implement. And I always wrote those proposals, actually. Even though we offered them something within their budget, we would know that it was impossible to deliver what they wanted within their budget. But we would just write a proposal that would fit their needs, their budget. But then their needs would come up during the project, and we had to say, yeah, sorry, but that's not in the budget, that's not in the project, it's not in the scope. If you want this, you will need to allocate more money. So every time there would be a conflict, and every time people would be pissed off and upset, like, well, you had to know this. Yeah, sorry, but actually you didn't want to make basically, this is what we agreed upon, this was what the money you were willing to invest in this project. If you need this, you will need to pay extra. Well, you have them by the balls, right? Because you already have a that's not really a good expression, because it's not very customer oriented, it's not very nice. And actually, it's kind of a betrayal when you.
Yeah, so those things, I think, many cases happen.
Yeah.
And this kind of conflict, both sides, they
right.
have.
Right. It's very nasty. It's not very nice. And it's, but almost every company does it. And it starts with, okay, people not willing to put enough budget or are too ambitious in their goals in relation to what money they want to spend. Like, okay, I really would like to have a Ferrari, but I only can afford a Nissan. So then the company comes and says, oh, yeah, yeah, sure. We can give you whatever you want. But then actually specifying a Nissan, and then people, hey, but actually I wanted to have a Ferrari. Well, actually, according to our contract, you bought a Nissan. But the customer cannot see that, not from the contract. And actually, the contract is not that well read anyway.
In my view, for example, some project which is ongoing, as long as that is kind of profitable, the by and large, this project is going to be profitable, then maybe 100% successful, 50% successful. Anyway, this project will generate profit.
Right.
I think that is not so bad. So worst case for me in some company I know is the problem is the top management is not they don't notice that what they're doing. So this means in
no hours, involvement. You mean?
They think they are involved. Then they think they are directing, but actually they don't know what they're doing. This means what this management is saying or they think is directing some the business is missing some point. Is so more directly they are doing something strange, but they don't notice.
Are you talking about the management of the supplier or from the customer side?
Management. I don't know. It could be both.
Right.
So any company. Some project which is something strange, something wrong, directed by the top management. I think maybe when we look at this from outside, I don't think it's so complicated. Too complicated to find some essential program in terms of they are doing something wrong, something strange. But if the top management doesn't have the sense of looking at some project, I mean, this project is not familiar with this management experience and some view. In this case, the problem is not so complicated, but it's easy for this top management to throw away his own view or own sense of what they should direct, what should pay some attention from making some mistake. For example, in this company, basically the business has been going down. But before, what they're doing is just they're visiting the customer from the morning to evening, then coming back to the company, then they have made some projects to get the revenue. So the direction of the top management on the sales team is just to go out, not stay in the office. So to make profit, most important point is you have to be out.
Feet on the street. I worked